in a distant land. Far into the future, with no music. Who will unlock the sounds of the past?
I repeat,
do not fear. Sound Impact is here. Sound Impact musicians stand united on board their time travel machine, venturing around the world through time, discovering musical treasures. Time to travel.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Have you ever had a time in your life when you wanted something to change, but you didn't know how to make that change? Was it frustrating to see something happen that was unfair to people around you, to animals, to the earth? Well, for years, we've used music around the globe to help us create change and spark revolution. This music comes from all different styles, like folk music.
Oh, the times they are changing.
Hip hop. Rock and roll. And spirituals.
All it takes is one person to help spark a revolution. Like Susan B. Anthony, who campaigned against slavery and for women's suffrage. Or Dr. Martin Luther King, who fought to end racial segregation as a leader of the American Civil Rights Movement. It can even be an entire country fighting for their independence. Today, we are going to visit moments in history where music helped spark revolution and change around the globe.
Time to travel!
Up, 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 everywhere!
We landed in Finland in 1899. Where we meet one of Finland's most famous composers, Jean Sibelius. During the 19th century, Finland was controlled by Russia, which borders it to the east. The Finnish people wanted to become a separate country and govern themselves, but Russia wanted to limit and control what the Finnish people could think or believe. This is called censorship. And that's where our musical hero, Jean Sibelius, comes in. Sibelius secretly wrote this piece of music and gave it some fake names, so at first it didn't catch the eyes of the Russian government. The piece we now call Finlandia is an important symbol of pride in Finland, and you can hear the deep cry for freedom and revolution in the music. It's interesting to hear how Sibelius used classical music to secretly spark a revolution in Finland. Let's travel now to a new country to hear how they fought for their freedom. Time to travel!
Up, 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 everywhere!
Bonjour les amis. We've landed in Quebec, Canada in 1975.
During the 1960s, just when the United States was experiencing the civil rights movement, the people of Quebec, Canada started to demand more control over their lives and their province. This time in history was called the Quiet Revolution, la Révolution tranquille, when the people of Quebec fought to preserve their own healthcare, education, and language. In 1975, poet and singer-songwriter Gilles Vigneault first performed Gens du Pays, People of the Country, in Montreal.
Became the unofficial anthem, and today, even though Quebec is part of Canada, Quebec still celebrates its history, culture, and traditions, among them by speaking French instead of English. Time to travel!
Up, 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 everywhere!
You probably remember the term suffrage from episode 9 and how it means the right to vote. In democratic countries, people vote for representatives who make the rules, and these rules affect everybody. Back in 1850 in the USA, only white men were allowed to vote, which meant they made all of the decisions about every important issue facing the citizens. Women were so frustrated that they started to fight for the same rights as these men. Leading women activists banded together, handing out petitions and asking Congress for a constitutional amendment. Despite many obstacles, women remained persistent in their pursuit of the right to vote and to have their voices heard. They protested in the streets and faced arrests and jail time. The movement for women's suffrage lasted until women were granted the right to vote in 1920.
Even once women were granted the right to vote, many American citizens were still denied these same rights. People of color continued to face discrimination and intimidation as they tried to vote and have their voices heard.
This discrimination led to many more protests, including the one in Selma. Similar to the music we heard in Finland and Quebec, the women in the suffrage movement wrote songs to express their desire for change. This song, with lyrics by Elizabeth Harbour, is set to a tune you may already know, My Country, 'Tis of Thee.
Country, now from thee claim we our liberty in freedom's name. Guarding home's altar fires, daughters of patriot sires, their zeal our own inspires, justice to
Lift Every Voice and Sing was written in 1899 to commemorate President Abraham Lincoln's birthday.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty.
James Weldon Johnson originally wrote the lyrics as a poem and his brother, J. Rosamond Johnson, later wrote the music to this important song. Loud as the rolling sea. In the 20th century, Lift Every Voice and Sing became an anthem for the civil rights movement and the African-American struggle for justice and equality. An important moment for the movement was in 1965, when Dr. Martin Luther King and other nonviolent activists organized a march on the streets of Selma, Alabama, to protest the discrimination and racism that prevented people of color from exercising their right to vote. Music played a big role in the civil rights movement. It was a way to communicate ideas, keep spirits high, and create a sense of unity among the protesters.
Lift Every Voice and Sing picks right up and really tells a more accurate and complete story of the experiences of Black people in America. My hope is that people who are not in the African American community will embrace the lyrics and understand the deep place of sorrow and yet hope that the lyrics of this song represent for Black people in America. Facing the
rising sun. Time to travel.
We've landed in 2020 in the USA, where we're seeing millions of people take to the streets to demand that people of color be treated fairly by the police and the justice system. These protests have sparked a worldwide movement to demand racial justice. It has already become one of the largest civil rights movements in modern day history. Music is a big part of this movement, with people taking part in all kinds of ways, both at home, in the studio, and on the streets. Now let's travel to Florida, where a young singer, Kedron Bryant, lives with his family. Kedron is just 13 years old, but he wrote and performed this very powerful song that has now become a modern-day anthem for equality. To stand, oh, but when I look around and I see what's being done to my kind every day, I'm being hunted as prey. My people don't want no trouble. We've had enough struggle. I just wanna live. God protect me. I just wanna live. I just wanna live.
So powerful. His song and his voice has inspired millions of people to stand up for equality. Classical musicians like us have been inspired to take action in new ways through our musical performances. After all, our instruments are one way we can cry out for change. One musician has started a movement called Take Two Knees, which is a call to action for classical musicians to use their voice and position to stand for equality with African Americans and Black people around the world. Watch this video by Anthony McGill, principal clarinetist of the New York Philharmonic, that has created a musical revolution for social justice and racial equality. Listen to the way Anthony McGill changes the mood of this well-known song by altering just a few notes. You may have recognized that song. Yes, that was America the Beautiful, but with a new twist. Like we learned in earlier episodes, we can use the musical language to change the feeling or mood of the music. In this performance, Anthony changed the notes from major to minor to express a different mood. We've been so inspired by Anthony McGill's activism, we're adding our own voices in support of equality in an effort to stop racism.
We've learned through our time travel adventure that music is so powerful in so many different ways. You helped us uncover the sounds of the past, and now it's time for our time travel machine to recharge. But first, let's review where we found our musical treasures.
Around the globe, from Korea to California,
Canada to India.
The universal language of music introduced us to
instrument makers,
composers,
animals,
dances,
new cultures and traditions,
stories of struggle,
new ways to build bridges,
and music's ability to spark change and revolution.
Time to recharge for now, but until we meet again, your mission is to
use your voice.
And
keep the music alive!
Make it a future you want to see.
Up, up, and away!
Filmed a Finlandia video in 80 degree weather in a jacket, scarf, ski gloves.
Wiggle your fingers and wiggle your toes.
Take action in new ways through our musical performance.
Thank you to all of you for making our time travel adventure possible. Remember, it's you who keeps the music alive. Until we meet again, up, up, and away!